Alright, well this is a pretty easy mulligan. This hand doesn't do anything. There's no disruption and it has a turn one grim as it. Alright, I don't think I mulligan this. It's got the surgical extraction, which I by no means am claiming will be dredged by itself, because that's just not true. But it is decent, and this hand does have a Jitte, so if I can get that going, that's good. That's a little slow, but it also has double ponder. Alright, so opponent, if your plan was to net you death ray shaman. Oh yeah. If your plan was to just pass, you should prop. Well, actually, that's not true. This is a mana full dredge, so the plan isn't always just pass. My opponent just ended up with a hand where they just want to discard. Of course, discarding just works so much less well against Deathrite Shaman. So, what to do? I guess I'm just pondering, looking for a green duel on turn two. My opponent's probably got a Street Wraith in hand, so I'm gonna try to find a green duel, and then I'm gonna Deathrite the Golgari Grave Troll, then my opponent's gonna cycle Street Wraith. Yeah, this is no good. Brainstorm, Force of Will, now. Duel. Nope. Land. So now I could cast one of these spells. What would that do for me? The advantage of leaving mana up is I get to use Deathrite Shaman on a spell, which I think is actually fine for me. Because again, if I have Deathrite going, then it's pretty good for me. So I think this is okay. So now, if my opponent cycles Street Wraith, I think I go for the surgical extraction in response. Right, so opponent did not cycle Street Wraith. I'm not using surgical because I think my opponent's got Street Wraith, like I said. All right, so this hits Narcomoeba and some stuff. And I'm going to exile Cabal Therapy in response. And let's see what my opponent does. Nothing so far. That's already the draw step. So now, opponent could have land and a spell, but given the opening hand of pass, it doesn't seem super likely. So now, opponent discards again, discards the Grave Troll. I'm still looking for green sources here. A land of some kind would be nice. All right, there's a Scalding Tarn. So let's draw a Scalding Tarn, play a land. And the question now is whether I want to keep the Force of Will that's on top. I guess since I have a Deathrite Shaman, I'm okay about that. So now the question is, since I've got some options here, I mean, I can Deathrite either the Grave Troll or the Stinkweed Imp. But I don't think that's actually what I want to do. I think I play Delver, leave up Surgical Extraction, and then I can crack Scalding Tarn to use Deathrite Shaman. The problem is I still think my opponent's got Street Wraith, and I think this protects me the most because I can Deathrite Dread Return or something along those lines. I really don't want to use Deathrite Shaman and run into Street Wraith. And obviously if I'm hitting, ooh, double Narcomoeba, okay, well that's a good Surgical Extraction target, I think. Yeah, and then that's actually nice because it lets me see whether I want to use the death right here. All right, so let's get Narcomoeba, and see what's in my opponent's hand. Well, it's not a Narcomoeba. And does my opponent have the Street Wraith? Opponent does have the Street Wraith. And so I'm going to stop this my opponent's turn because now opponent does a breakthrough. So now I want to kill the Cabal Therapy and then be able to Force of Will to breakthrough here. So let's do that. All right, so I got all four Narcomoebas, or all three Narcomoebas rather. All right, so I do that. And then actually I guess I don't need a stop set there. So now this is unfortunate because it keeps me away from green sources still, but I actually think it's what I want to do since I do need to stop myself from getting Cabal Therapied for Force of Will before my opponent casts Breakthrough. So what could I have done differently? I guess I could have cracked Scalding Tarn, but I thought I might need to use the death right for green, so I wanted to leave Scalding Tarn up. All right, so killing Cabal Therapy, opponent's only play now. Oh, I guess you're cycling Street Wraith in response. Okay. That's fine, I suppose. You can't hit any more creatures. Opponent can hit a bunch of Icarids is the only thing. They're obviously not coming out this turn. So opponent didn't hit the other Cabal Therapy. The Archimedes don't come into play. Now my opponent's going to probably just go for the Breakthrough since you don't. There's no Cabal Therapies in sight. So land, Breakthrough, and I'm going to force it since I have to. And then next turn, hopefully flip Delver, and then play GTA. Actually, I guess I don't really care too much whether I flip Delver or not. I can play GTA, equip it, and attack, and then there's... Yeah, there's a Stinkweed, two Stinkweed Imps in the yard, so I definitely want to counter this. So even if Delver's not under control, having... even if Deathrite Shaman is not going off, Delver can still... kill the Narcomoeba and kill the Icarid. And opponent doesn't have a bridge right now. And can't discard to hand size because it played some cards. So these games have actually been pretty interesting. I mean, Street Wraith fights against Deathrite Shaman fairly effectively. Oh, and I got attacked, which is even better. Since now I actually don't care whether I flipped over or not. Well, that was the worst possible card. So Exile, Cephalid Colosseum, Jitte. Opponent does have Nature's Claim, but I'm going to get two counters in the GTA. I'm going to kill the Narcomoeba here right away. And then now I've got, because Delver didn't flip, I've got a GTA ready to fire off at Delver. So let's actually stop my opponent's draw step, because my opponent's going to dredge and I want to be able to potentially use the GTA afterwards. All right, Cabal Therapy I don't care about. And Dread Return is not happening anytime soon. So, no reason to kill the Icarid now. I'm going to get Nature's Claimed here. And I guess, let's just kill the Icarid. Sure. So I guess I should have just done that anyway. Yeah, whatever. Alright. You're dead, and then my opponent can't really do much else this turn. Faithless Looting. Unfortunately, there's two Faithless Lootings. Alright, well, I'm going to reveal that because I want to flip Delver. Opponent's on 12. Do I play Chune Nemesis or not? That's actually kind of interesting. So Icarid's coming back next turn. I'm going to get my Dazed Cabal Therapied. So I think I hit an Exile Cabal Therapy here. And this puts my opponent to 7. It's not lethal next turn, but I'm not getting outraced by Icarids. My opponent's going to run out of things to feed them anyway. This way I daze... Actually, I guess I should have waited to draw step this, since my opponent is going to get to dredge here. I should have draw stepped the Deathrite Shaman. Alright. And... Icarid. Draw, dredge, Stinkweed Imp. Alright, didn't hit... anything. I mean, hit Bridge from below, so opponent's gonna actually get. So I'm gonna go to 10, and then my opponent's gonna get 3 tokens, but next turn can only bring back a couple of grids. And I wanted to keep Daze alive, though. Actually, maybe that didn't matter too much. So if I draw a Bolt, I just win. Even if I don't, I can play True Nemesis, have 2 blockers for Icarids and slash tokens, and kill my opponent with Delver. Alright. So you get some tokens. Scalding Tarn. Does let me remove something for green, which is good. It's a hit. And play True Name Nemesis. And next turn, my opponent can bring in 2 Icarids, and I can block an Icarid and take 9. And then if my opponent brings in 2 Icarids, they're not dredging here. And my opponent does have a Dread Return, which is something I've got to be aware of. Though actually, I think I just... Well, I'm going to pass, I'm going to let Icarid trigger, and then I think I'm going to eat one of the Icarids so my opponent cannot bring back 2 Icarids. Actually, is that right? No, that's not right. I'm going to eat Stinkweed Imp, so my opponent can't bring back 2 Icarids. And that leaves 1 Icarid coming back, and then my opponent not hitting, being able to dredge into a good Dread Return target is the idea. Right, so is that all right? Should I have left the Delver back? Did that matter? Nope, I go to 11. All right, so now one Ikrid can come into play. I can daze a flashed back Faithless Looting, though that's actually still not insane because there's no dredge cards. And then if my opponent were to dredge into somehow a dredge turn target, I could be in trouble, but I've got daze to stop again some of those shenanigans. Opponent's gonna have to have something pretty good, like a Cephalid Colosseum. Cycling Street Wraith going to two, but just drawing, not dredging. So I think I'm actually good here. The Surgical Extraction was pretty key, and then having Deathrite Shamans was pretty key. I mean, Deathrites were good, but they weren't alone. I mean, we had definitely had games otherwise, so that was interesting. But it worked out, and I beat Dredge, which is kind of the enemy.